Namaste everyone. I hope you had fun with Observable.range. And if you haven't watched the video yet, then you can watch the video from the link on the description or the card. So in this video, we are going to use another factory method called Observable.defer. So let's not waste any more time and jump right into my screen. Okay, wait, what are all these codes? It's the same code we have written on the previous Sunday episode where we have discussed observable.range. So let's add one more observer here. But before we run, let's modify the count to 3 before we add the second observer. Now we do expect that observer 1 will print 5 and 6 and observer 2 will print 5, 6 and 7. So let's run and see what happens. But wait, both are printing the same numbers. If you are thinking that we have called the observable.range method with the count already and then we modified the count here, so range method is obviously holding the old value. You are absolutely correct. But what if we really care about the state changes? When the count modifies anywhere in the code, we want the range method to use the updated count. I mean, that's what we call reactive, right? So to do this, we have a great factory method called observable.defer. So observable.defer takes an instance of callable. But one thing to notice here is that callable should be a type of observable source. So if we check our range method, we can see that it is returning an observable. An observable is nothing but an observable source as it implements observable source. So we clearly know that we can pass an instance of observable that we get from observable.range in here. So let's use the lambda here. And let's run. And there we go, we get the expected output here. If you have watched our observable.error episode, then you can somehow relate to this, where we have created a separate instance of exception every time. And this observable.defer works just like this. A new observable.range is getting created for every subscriber. So let's add a helpful print statement to understand what's going on here. And let's run and see what it prints. So as you can see here, before publishing, the new observable is being created. So everyone gets the new value here. As you can see here that observer 2 gets the updated count. That was easy, right? But if you still have any confusion, then you can comment below or message me on any of my social handles. And if you like this video, don't forget to hit the subscribe and bell icon so you don't miss our videos that we upload every Sunday. It's Mithu here signing off. Thank you for stopping by. See you next Sunday.